Hello friends, welcome back to the online classes. We have already started the new chapter, lesson number 3, The Midnight Visitor. And yesterday I had given you a summary as well as started the chapter. So a little recap before we continue the chapter. We had seen that Ossabel is a secret agent and Fowler is a writer who want to write the story of Ossabel, that how he works, how he does all the things about. And but being with him, he did not find anything exciting so far. He was very much bored up. And as they were coming to the hotel, Ossabel also, you can say that he was trying to make fun of him. So he says to Fowler that you may be thinking that how I could be a secret agent, because I am very fat, ugly in looking. I'm not looking at all looking in good. I mean, I'm not so attractive. I'm not so fast because of my fatness. And I am very short also in height. So how could I be be an agent? And they just came into the hotel and they were going towards their room. Now in the hotel, his room was on the 6th floor, okay, the top of the topmost floor of the hotel. And he goes on telling to Fowler that he may be thinking that what an ugly place I had taken you, a restaurant where hardly anybody would like to go, and there also there was not much exciting. You may be thinking that the secret agent may be a person who has got a very good built personality, who is very good in looking, attractive, and who may be having lots of girls here and there, and a lot of romantic person it could be, as you yourself is. As he goes on speaking, he opens the door and asks directs the Fowler to get inside. He comes inside and he also get inside, and as closes the door, Fowler sees one more man sit in his room. Okay, he was standing there with his automatic pistol, and he says Ossabel, when sees that man, he also was a bit surprised, but he took it casually and says, "Oh, Max," the other fellow, name was Max, he also was a secret agent. So he says, "Hello, Max, what are you doing in my room? I was thinking that you would be in Berlin." Then Max said that, "Yeah, I know. First of all, you be careful. I have got a pistol and it is pointed towards you. So don't be smart, or else I will shoot you." Now, Ossabel had to protect the secret document which was coming, and he had to even save his life as well as Fowler's life. So he just moves towards his armchair and sits there very casually. He doesn't take it very, he doesn't show that he is surprised, he is shocked, he is frightened or nervous, nothing. He just take it casually and just goes and sits on the armchair. There he sits and he goes talking with the Max. No, then Max says that, "I have come to help you with that secret document that you are going to get today. I thought that I would come personally and take it from you so that I could help you with that heavy responsibility." Then Ossabel invents a story from here. He says that, "I will be complaining to the management of the hotel," because he had been telling them to look after the balcony which is there beside the window. So as he says, Fowler also looks towards the window, because The window was very simple, a very simple window, and no one could think that there would be a balcony. And he says that Osible goes on saying that I've been telling them that there could be a problem for me because anybody could come easily from through that balcony. Now Max tells that anyhow I do not know whether there was balcony or not, because I have come to your room through the pass key, the duplicate key I had taken, I had made it and came through the entrance door. So I was not knowing if it was there, it would have been very easy for me. Why? Because he could have gone and hidden in the balcony and would have waited till the secret documents had come. He need not to be there in front of him right now before the document comes, because if he does that now, as he's standing there, Osible may be thinking, planning and all, no, right? How to save himself and his fellow friend and the documents and all. Whereas if he was on the balcony, then he would not have made any kind of plans and all, because he was not knowing. That's why he just said, so Max said that if it was there, if I was knowing about it, then I would not have done something else. I would not have come from this place, whereas I would have been hiding in the balcony itself. So up to here we had finished. So let us continue. Page number 16. Okay. It is not my balcony, Osible said with extreme irritation. It belongs to the next apartment. He glanced explanatorily at Fowler. You see, he said, this room used to be part of a large unit, and the next room through that door there used to be the living room. It had the balcony which extends under my window now. You can get onto it from the empty room two doors down, and somebody did last month. The management promised to block it off, but they haven't. Now, Osible explains that why this balcony is. He says that this balcony is not of my room. Then he explains, looking at Fowler, saying that this room was once, it was very big room. It was like a hall type room it was. But the management closed it down. They have raised this wall between in this hall, divided them into two rooms, and in that the other room is having the door towards the balcony which extends up to his window. Now he had already told about this, because last month someone had come into his room through the window, because the other room somebody came entered, and from the balcony he came towards his window and got inside the room, and he had complained about this to the management, and they had promised that they will definitely do something. They will block that door so that no one could enter the balcony. Max glanced at Fowler, who was standing stiffly not far from Osible, and waved the gun with a commanding gesture. Please sit down, he said. We have a wait of half an hour, I think. So Max, after some time, Max looked at Fowler, who was still standing. He was still frightened. He could not move out of fear. He could not move. He was simply standing there. So he had the whole body was stiff. He could not move at all. That much fear he was having. So Max looked at him and told him, asked him to sit down on the chair, and told him that we have to wait. There will be some waiting, almost for half an hour something, till the those papers come, those documents come. So we have to wait for half an hour. So no need of standing for that long. You can sit there. 31 minutes, Osible said moodily. The appointment was for 12:30. I wish I knew how you learned about the report, Max. So when he said that half an hour or so, Osible said exactly 31 minutes, because he says that Osible says that the appointment that he had fixed is about middle of the night, that is 12:30. So 12:30 the fellow will come with the document. So that is the time that he has given. And then he asks Max that he want to know that how he came to know about these documents, these secret documents. The little spy smiled evilly, and we wish we knew how your people got the report. But no harm has been done. I will get it back tonight. What is that? Who is at the door? So the Max simply smiles and says that, of course, you know that we also want to know that how your people came to know about this document. We are also want to know about it, that how they came to know about this document and how they got it. Anyhow, that's no problem. Today, tonight, I will get those documents easily, so you need not to worry about it. Then suddenly he hears someone knocking on the door. So he just asks that, who is there? What is that? Who is at the door? Fowler jumped at the sudden knocking at the door. Ossible just smiled. That will be the police, he said. I thought that such an important paper as the one we are waiting for should have a little extra protection. I told them to check on me to make sure everything was all right. Max bit his lips nervously. The knocking was repeated. Now, Fowler immediately jumped. The moment the door was knocked, Fowler immediately jumped. He got frightened because now something will happen. Now, someone is knocking the door and Max may get angry and he may start shooting. No, that's why he got frightened. So, he jumped. And then Ossible smiled and said that it is the police. And he gives a reason why the police has come. He says that since the documents are very important, so I had told the nearby police station that please keep on checking on me, even in the middle of the night, that I'm there or not, because it's very important papers. So anybody can come and snatch from me or kill me or hurt me, something could be done. That's the reason that I have told him, and it could be that they have come here to find out whether everything is all right. The knocking goes harder. Max get nervous, get worried, tensed of what to do, because he needs to get those papers. And if by chance if the police is there, and even if he shoots them, if he tries to run away, they will break the door and get inside and could catch him or kill him. So he was a bit worried. What will you do now, Max? Ossible asked. If I do not answer the door, they will enter anyway. The door is unlocked and they will not hesitate to shoot. So now Ossible is trying to make Max more worried and more tense. So he asked Max, now what are you going to do, my dear fellow? Because they can enter anytime. The door is unlocked only. I have not locked. It is just shut. So they can open at any time, and if they see the gun in your hand, they will immediately open fire at you and they will kill you. So what are your plans now? What are you going to do? Max's face was black with anger as he backed swiftly towards the window. He swung a leg over the sill. Send them away, he warned. I will wait on the balcony. Send them away or I will shoot and take my chances. The knocking at the door became louder and a voice was raised. Mr. Ossible, Mr. Ossible. Now, Max's face was very black and he was filled with anger. He was not knowing what to do. Suddenly, he remembered that there is a balcony outside the window. Remember what Ossible had said in the beginning, that there is a balcony, and he was upset with the management and asked them to close it because last month someone had climbed in. So he remembered, oh, balcony is there, no, I will go and hide behind the window in the balcony and keep a look on them. And he says to Ossible that get rid of them fast, don't be clever, don't be smart. No, I am standing there in the balcony. I will wait in the balcony till they go from the room. So you should not be clever. You should not show any smartness, or else I will shoot you immediately. Okay. So get rid of them as early as possible. And he starts moving backwards. and the knocking goes on loudly, and from outside the person calls the name of Osborne, Mr. Osborne, Mr. Osborne. No? So this made more tense to Max. Keeping his body twisted so that his gun still covered the fat man and his guest, the man at the window grasped the frame with his free hand to support himself. Then he swung his other leg up and over the window sill. So, keeping his gun towards, pointing towards Osborne and Fowler, he went back towards the window. He put his leg, one leg outside the window, hanging a little bit because he could not reach full down because one leg was already inside. And then he came with the other leg outside and went behind the window. He was just there still behind the window sill, pointing the gun towards Osborne and Fowler. The doorknob turned swiftly. Max pushed with his left hand to free himself from the sill and dropped to the balcony. And then, as he dropped, he screamed once freely. Now, the doorknob opened by itself. The person who was standing outside opened the doorknob, turned the doorknob and opened the door. Seeing this, he immediately pushed himself, no? From the window. When we jump out of the window, we push ourselves, right? To land on the balcony, he pushed himself and he just straight away went down. And when he found that there is no balcony, a shrill sound, screaming sound came from there, and after some time it was dead. The door opened and a waiter stood there with the tray, a bottle and two glasses. "Here is the drink you ordered for when you had returned," he said, and set the tray on the table. He deftly uncorked the bottle and left the room. So the door opened and the waiter came inside with a bottle and two glasses, which Osborne had ordered the waiter when they came inside the room so that they can wait. No, they had to wait, so they had to be awake. So till then, they can spend a little time with this wine, to drink the wine. White-faced Fowler stared after him, but he stammered, "The police?" "There were no police," Osborne sighed. "Only Henry, whom I was expecting." So he just knew that Osborne experienced that I was expecting Henry only. Now this fellow was worried. Fowler, that how, because he was thinking the police will come, and he said, "No, there is no police. I was expecting Henry only, because then when we came into the hotel, I had asked Henry to bring some one bottle and two glasses so that we can spend time." Then he says, Fowler says, "Then what about Max?" And then he says, "Come on, friend, you know that there is no balcony outside the window, and he is no more there. I hope you might have understood the story. Thank you. Have a nice day."